for me. It's your boy Zion Ali. A couple days ago, I went to the Forge. They was having some type of music festival, so I just went out there to go meet some new artists. Turns out, they're actually pretty dope. Let's meet them.
Hey, Zion.
Hey, what is this?
Hey, do your job, security. Whoop, plop,
these ain't no real motherfucking security.
Damn, she pulling out the car.
Oh, not the baby. Oh, shit, she beating her ass. Hey, make sure you keep this in the clip too. Keep all this. Yeah, all this shit.
Yo, we live with OG fucking P. It's only me, the biggest, you know what I'm saying? We had a recording line. We just did another fucking show out here in Indiana, you know, with the Indiana moves. Dab that way, you know what I'm saying? I'm here with Zion, you know what I'm saying?
Ooh, Dom DeMarco.
Just came out the club.
Rock these hoes. Rock
the fucking show. I'm trying to tell you. You know what time it is. Look, what's up, bro? How you doing?
Let me get up.
Yes, sir. Ski.
How long you been rapping, bro?
Oh, look, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. You know what I'm saying? I've been rapping for probably about a few years. I ain't gonna lie to you, but I really started taking it serious probably like October 1st when I got out of prison and shit, you know what I'm saying? No bullshit, ain't no judge, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, we had a pass.
What made you want to rap?
You know, I got an older brother, you know what I'm saying? But he in prison right now, you know what I'm saying? His inspiration for music and shit just kept me going with it. I fell into it, and then it ain't never stopped.
So I'm assuming your brother just influenced you to rap. Did your brother rap too?
Yeah, he make music, yeah, but he a singer. You know what I'm saying? He make all kind of music. He play instruments and all types of shit. So you feel me? He love Jimi Hendrix and shit. So you feel me? His inspiration for music. I just been around him so much, and you know what I'm saying? Just seeing him make music, it just inspired me to do more.
For sure.
Hell yeah. So you know what I'm saying?
What's your message? Not to the kids or like, or for the people, but when people listen to your music,
right,
or people look at you, what do you want them to think about?
I want people to open their mind and be woke, you know what I'm saying? Open up that third eye, don't be in this matrix, you know what I'm saying? Just keep moving and do as best as you can by yourself. You don't need nobody, don't ask nobody, don't put your hand out for nothing, go get it. You can always go get a bag by yourself.
What's your goal for 2024?
Get a bigger bag. I'm trying to eat, you know what I'm saying? We hungry, so we gonna keep eating. And I'm gonna just let y'all know, all the artists and stuff like that, humbly, I'm coming.
Go, man. It's been a minute, man.
How you been?
Better than ever, man. Everything, my life, man, crazy since the last interview.
So what's new, man?
New shows, new hoes, new clothes, new flows. You heard? Word two. So it better be hot. Smack the fuck out you.
it's the same mission?
Always. The goal, you know, the plan is to get out, feed the children, get our peoples out, man. That's, you know, anything other than that, tweak you, worry about the wrong shit. Just do the same plan, do the same, man. You never gonna change. It's SBS shit in my blood.
Any music we need to look out for?
Yeah, I got a mixtape on the way. Welcome to Bowlands. Welcome to the Bowlands. Mixtape on the way. Y'all go look out for that too. And I got singles and shit dropping, features. I got some features on the way. Nothing too big, but with some artists that I think that y'all should be hearing, you feel me? So, yeah. Okay, cool. How y'all doing? I love the Black Melanated Queens. Tight shit. You got that donkey called Shrek. Hey, I made her laugh.
Hi.
You got that donkey called Shrek.
All right.
My name is Keith Love, and if you got a bitch that don't know what the issue is, then let me say what's up. Go ahead and rap.
Let's go. Let's go. Talk to him. Yeah.
What's up, bitch? What's the issue? Lay my eyes on this issue. What's up, bitch? What's the issue? Eating them up, bitch, I'm biting.
Yeah.
What's up,
bitch? What's the issue?
No gorilla, no
cheap stuff. How long you been rapping?
4 years.
4 years?
About a year now, yeah.
What inspires you to rap?
Listening to music.
Who inspires you to rap?
Myself.
So you had no way.
Other artists, like, I mean, Lakim. Yeah, Lakim the show. To have my music noticed in more than 5 states.
That's good. Okay. What's your message? Not to the kids, but like for yourself when people look at you or listen to your music.
When you hear my music, turn the fuck up. Get out of whatever mood you in, just turn the fuck up and just, you know what I'm saying? Listen to my music and know, like, okay, I'm cool. Now Keith Lowe got me right together. Period.
What's your goal for 2024? 2024. I just plan to get a lot accomplished for as far as business. I plan to probably do a lot more networking, a lot more behind the scenes action with the camera. That's my specialty. I do a lot of A&R work, so I plan to get a lot more rappers and singers, and maybe some actors on our team as well. So that's coming up in 2024. Golden Line coming up in 2024. We got about two or three highly distinguished. That's a clothing line I got going on. One of my brothers, he got a clothing line called Residuals. And then there's another clothing line called Cozier Clothing. So, you know, we working, we doing big things right now. 2024 should be big for Wavy Entertainment, for me personally, and then for all of you if you connect with us. So let me know, you know, connect with me on the social media platform, and you know, hear that music from the phone. So.
What's up, y'all? My name is Mary Rose Crow. I'm an artist. I was born in Italy, and I'm now here in Chicago just trying to get this shit pumping.
Let's go. Sure. How long you been rapping?
I've been making music since I was honestly in eighth grade. I've always been writing music my whole life, but I actually stepped foot in the studio for the first time in eighth grade, and now I'm 26 and a bitch been making new music. I found my sound. I wouldn't say there's been lost time necessarily, but I would say that the sound is now developed. A bitch can thrive in her lane. You get what I'm saying? So
sure.
Yeah. That's how I really feel, type shit. And now we just out here trying to do shows, put out this music, which honestly, the unfortunate part of all this is that all my music's in my vault, but it is slowly coming out. So yeah.
Is this your first show?
It's not my first show, but I be doing shows like this, but I just took a little like 3-year thing where I went MIA because, you know, life. But yeah, in those 3 years I've been in the stew. It's not like I haven't been working. It's just I didn't keep doing shows, type shit.
What inspired you to rap?
To be honest, I have always been the type of person that I don't like being vulnerable, like on a one-on-one type of thing. I always felt like when I make music, I could somehow like ventilate. It's a decompression technique for me, and then when I found out I can make the shit sound sick as fuck and decompress at the same time, that shit was just a hit.
Who inspires you to rap?
Shout out to Nicki Minaj. I'm from Italy and rap is not a thing in Italy, at least not when I was out in Italy. I know like Italian rap scene like has definitely come up and shit, but when I was in Italy, that shit was definitely not a thing. So when I stepped foot in Chicago, a bitch was young, but I did start listening to what was, honestly, I don't know how it came across my desk type shit, but when I heard that shit, it just inspired me to, like, when I see Nicki Minaj do it on the Come Up DVDs, this ain't no, like, Lil Wayne even co-signed her yet type shit. I don't even, like I said, I don't know how this shit came across my shit, my eyes, but I'm happy it did, because that shit made me realize I can pinpoint my type of music, because, like I said, I've always been writing. I figured out, I like how it sounds to do play on words. I like how it sounds to rhyme. I like how it sounds to have punchlines. Like, that's one of my favorite things is when someone's listening to my shit and they're like, what the fuck did she just say? You know, so Nicki Minaj definitely, as a youngin', definitely made a bitch inspired. Okay. I was like, she looks raw as fuck doing this shit. I want to do it too.
What's your message? Not to the children, but like when somebody listens to your music or when somebody looks at you or looks at your content, what do you want them to feel?
I think for me, we'll let the cars pass. I think for me, the fact that through music, I'm able, well, you're asking what my message is.
Yeah.
My message is pretty much to let people understand, women specifically, that everything you see a dude doing on an independent level, how men get praised for the shit that they be doing. I just feel like women don't know deep down inside, like, we some boss ass people too. We a boss ass being. And you look at a man like you gotta be with a rich motherfucker. Why don't you be the rich motherfucker?
Why don't you be a rich motherfucker?
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Rich motherfucker.
So it's just one of those things where it's like put in work. I'm not saying compare yourself to a man, but I'm just saying like the work ethic that people get pedestaled on and praised for. That's just a human trait. That's not a gender trait. That's like, go hard and hard ass shit's gonna come out of that shit. My message is just do your shit.
Okay, groovy. What's your goal for 2024?
I want to let this music vault breathe. I need to let this music drop because
we're trying to blow.
Yeah, we trying to go up.
We trying to blow,
shawty. We trying to go up for sure.
Okay. Yeah, we got eyes watching. We got a lot of big motherfuckers watching our shit, so.
Yeah, but he asked me what's pro for. My last name, like I said, I'm Italian. My last name is Provenzano. The first three letters of my last name is pro. Mm. And the Latin root word pro stands for anything positive. Mm. So that's just kind of who the fuck I am in three letters, you feel me?
Okay, Groovy, is there anything else you want to let the audience know?
I do want to shout out my people back here. This is Mimi J Makeup. She goes hard as fuck on the beats. She be doing my makeup for my music videos and shit, and just be doing makeup in general, going hard as fuck. This is my bitch Kudaranka. Tell them your Instagram name.
My Instagram is Thicky, but you could call me Shay Money.
And she's been with me since day one. She was like one of the only people actually to pop out to my shows. Back in the day when it was hole in the wall ass shows, this was the only person that would pop out with me. It was just me. She would be in the crowd, and whoever the fuck else was there was there type.
Oh, she for sure was supporting you. I seen it.
Hell yeah. And this is Brittany. She just decided to pop out with some real bitches
this
tonight.
This is my bitch.
So.
I brought her out tonight.
Okay, Groovy, thank you so much.
But my name is Mary Rose Pro, like I said, and that's my Instagram. That's all my music platforms is Mary Rose Pro. So, yeah, beat me there. Yeah.
HMG CEO Big Cheese.
How long y'all been making music?
I've been doing this for like 2 years now.
About you? I've been the CEO of this label for 2 years.
Okay, what inspired you to start this?
Well, he did. This was his dream. I'm talking about I invested in his dream. Instead of investing in bonds and funerals and all that, why not invest in his future? I get a better payback.
Right.
That's why we started this label.
Yeah, for sure. When I go through a lot of depression, that helped me get out of my zone and get to a different zone.
For sure. Especially losing a lot of people to the system and to the grave. We gotta put it off sometime.
So, is there any artist in particular that influenced you to rap?
My late great cousin, FBG Duck.
God, shit, Duck. You know, my hashtag is Shug Diddy. I wanna be the best CEO in the game.
Yeah.
I wanna be the best leader like Diddy and a boss like Shug.
God.
For sure. What's y'all goals for 2024?
Take over
again.
Take over.
Yeah.
Everybody
know
who HMG is.
They're
gonna know who HMG is by the end of
2024. For sure, for sure. I do this every time.
We're
gonna rock out and go home with it. Secure
every
time.
Every time. For sure. What's your message, not to the people or to the children, but like when people listen to your music or when people meeting you or look at your content, what do you want them to feel? What are you projecting?
Best for the new generation.
That fight depression. My music is for people that go through the ups and the downs and don't try to get rid of it and try to go through it head first.
Yeah, just want the generation to be better. Feel me? Everybody out the streets, go put it in the books, go put it in the studio, go do something better with your life. All picking up guns and stuff, it ain't working. Get out of that. It ain't working, bro.
It's only two options, dead or in the grave.
It ain't working, bro.
Is there anything else you want the camera to or the people to know?
Watch out for HMG 2024.
And we got a cornerstone in Toledo.
Yes, sir.
803 Mark.
803 Bush Street.
Y'all pull up on
Toledo, Ohio.
I'm there every day.
Every day.
HMG the best way.
Whatever. Yeah.
For sure.
Get your switch of leads, all that. You got throwbacks, all that.
We the cheapest in the city, too.
50 cent pops, ice cold. 50 cent pops. Who would still do $1 for two pops?
Yeah.
HMG be taking over the world.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Pussy nigga, yo, pussy nigga, yo, pussy nigga, yo, pussy nigga, yo, peon. Pension nigga, long time, eons. Bitch, I'm prime time, Dion. Real life movie, no rerun. Sold, not told, no refund. Disappear, voila, be gone. Disappear, voila, be gone.
What up, man? It's your boy, the Black Bully, aka Big Homie himself, man.
How long you been making music?
Since 2019.
What inspires you to make music?
Journey inspires me more, man. Yeah. The more things I do, the more places I go, just make me want to do more.
Is there any artist in particular that inspired you?
Me?
I feel that. feel that. What's your goal for 2024?
Harder than I went last year. Go harder than I went the year before.
And
my only competition.
I feel that. What's your message? Not your message to the kids or to the people, but like when somebody listens to your content, or somebody listens to your music, or watches your content and listens to your music, what do you want them to feel? What are you projecting?
That Grammy's still here, man. That Grammy's still here. You know, and just really, I don't know. I'm not sure, man, honestly. I just want people to, you know, enjoy it like I do. I have fun with it. I just want somebody to enjoy it. Enjoy it like I do.
What's going on, guys? My name is Akid LV. I just finished up a show here. I'm with my little cousin, but I just needed to be here to promote my single, Family, around 9/8, September 8th. I'm super hyped. We put in a ton of work to get here, and I'm super excited to finally have this coming up.
All right, for sure. How long you been making music, man?
So I started about 3 years ago, seriously, professionally, but I've made music my whole life. I've always loved music, and I picked up instruments and other stuff, but like, I recently got into this like about 3 years ago, and I just ran with it, man. Like, I just ran with it and never went back.
What inspired you to make music?
Just past music people have made, leaving its mark on me, and I wanted to be able to do that for someone else. Like, if I can help someone with my music, even if it's one person, two people, whatever, like, that's enough for me to keep doing it every day. You know what I mean? So.
That's groovy.
A lot of stories to
my
music, too. A lot of stories.
That's groovy.
He keeps me motivated, man. Like, I told him from day one, we're going to be touring together one day. He's going to be in the tour bus. He's going to have to...
It's funny as hell. He shows up with some new music from the studio, and I'll look him straight in the eyes and be like, bro, this shit's ass. Skip. New song. And he'll go right back to the studio and work on a new thing, put it out in a week, and there you go. You got it.
That's what it takes. That's what it takes. And it's family, so that's what makes it awesome.
Keep it real.
What's your goal for 2024?
That's a really good question. So this is the first single I've really had like major marketing and video help for and stuff. Mm. And I just really want to continue that momentum and not just drop and then stop. Like, I really just want to continue that momentum, just keep filming videos, just keep making music, just everything I need to be doing, just keep building a ball, keep making as much of it as possible. That's my goals, man. I mean, obviously I want the streams and the shows and all that, but I mean, I just got those personal goals. I really want to crank out those videos, those songs, get those out to the world. It's been way too long before the world's heard any of my music. It's been a year, so.
That's groovy. What's your message? Not to the kids or to the people, but like, when people listen to your music or when people look at you or meet you, what do you want them to feel? What are you projecting?
Spread love, spread positivity, be genuine, be kind. You know what I mean? Like, it gets you so much further in this life, like just doing the right thing and not thinking twice about it. Just do the right thing. It pays off. That's how I've gotten as far as I've gotten with this, and I'm just going to continue being me, and I'm just going to continue being genuine to people. And whether I get it back or not, that's just how I want to carry myself and how I want people to see me. You know what I mean?
That's groovy. Anything else you want to tell the camera?
Kid LV official on Instagram.
You ready for 2024?
Thank you from me and the Cuzzo. It means the world to us, for real. And thanks for the interview, dog.
For sure. Thank you. For sure.
Appreciate you.
Hey, yo, it's your Spacey. We just rocked out at the Forest. Let's get it. Cash!
How long you been making music, bro?
Man, I've been making music for about, seriously, like 3 years, 3-4 years. Since like 2020.
What inspires you to make music?
Lil Uzi Vert, Juice WRLD, Trippy Red, PnB Rock, Bone Thugs and Harmony. I say even singers inspire me, bro. New Edition, Michael Jackson, man, fucking, that's about it, bro. That's all inspire me, really.
All right, what motivates you to make music? What motivates you to make music?
My brother passed away. Rest in peace, Gordo. Gordo went for life. He passed away. Made my drive harder. Made it a purpose. It made this dream become just a dream that, you know, some people want to chase to a purpose, an end game. It's going to be, we all make it out. I put on everybody. Take care of his family. Take care of my family. Take care of everybody's family type shit. That's the end game. That's what motivates me every day.
That's dope. What's your goal for 2024?
Goal for 2024, bro, we about to make it. That's what I want. I'm trying to get features with real artists. I'm trying to get on some producer shit. I'm trying to travel the world. Shit, I'm trying to do something different in 2024. Different level of me.
Okay. What's your message? Not to the kids or to the people, but when people look at you or listen to your music.
My message, bro?
Yeah.
Right now, as long as you can cut out all the hate and all the shit and you just love doing you, bro, a lot of motherfuckers get it over their heads when they say, hey, just do you and don't quit and you'll make it. Motherfuckers, that shit go over so many motherfuckers' heads, bro. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't let nobody hate on you. Don't let no goofy-ass shit happen. At the end of the day, shit might happen.
Is there anything else you want to let the people know?
I got, stay out from drugs. Stay out from pills.
Stay out from the drugs, bro. Ain't worth it.
Everything I love.
Everything I love,
it ain't worth it.
For sure. Are there any projects you're...
I got a collab mixtape with EB Tezo. It's called The Flies. We're going to do The Flies shit. I got a single September 8th. It's dropping everywhere with a video from Red Tape District, Zay Visuals. Y'all tap in. And I got a whole mixtape dropping next year called Space Jam. We about to turn the fuck up.
I bet. Well, can't wait to see it, man. Thank you.
I appreciate it, gang.
What inspired you to rap? What inspired you to rap?
Well, when I grew up, my dad was a DJ, so all I ever heard this when I was growing up was music. So it kind of made me think of how it would be if I was to express myself and putting my own music out there instead of listening to everybody else. So I thought I'd give it a try and see where shit goes, you know?
For sure. What's your goal for 2024?
My goal for 2024 is definitely get the more views on them streams and get a bigger name for myself than I am now, you know? To me, progress is key every day, so as long as I'm progressing and stay consistent in my shit, I just hope that, you know, from there it takes off on its own base.
For sure. Is there any artist in particular that inspired you?
Artists. I mean, I do really fuck with Lil Durk, obviously, because he was born and raised in Chicago. So he's my little inspiration. He just shows me that if he could do it, anybody can from the rap. So, you know, my music is a little different from his, but that's what I try to do. I try to be different, versatile. You know, I ain't trying to be like everybody else right
now. For sure. What's your message? Not your not the message to the kids, to the people, but like, when people listen to your music or look at you or look at your content, what do you want them to feel? What are you projecting?
Well, my message is my story. I want people to understand how I'm feeling, what I'm thinking, and just know that, you know, everyone is going through the same shit. It might be different shit, but we're all going through the same, you know, pain, whatever. But I just hope that, you know, my music helps other people get listening to what they really want to hear.
Told that boy, it's only certain shit that you can speak on. Little bit time to go, I say the throw like I'm a hero. Niggas got they back against the wall, I'm rockin' V-Long. Shorty say get groovin' like Mike Elch, just get your freak on. Hold on.
Y'all already know what the fuck going on, man. Get right, Keezy, man. Get right, CEO, man. It's your boy 10K Kobe, man. Big Tim, Mr. Countin' fucking dividends on my
feet. Big Tim.
One of the hottest in the rap, boy, Chicago, KD the rapper, man.
Hey, get ready to get left, Drewski, man. You know what the fuck going on.
Snap that, my boy, Drewski, man.
So how long everybody been rapping?
Yeah, we've been doing this shit. Man, folks been going on like 10 years.
No, it's like
15. It's like
6, 2
more years.
It's been 6, 7. No, don't do that. Don't scare you.
2015. If we do 2015, do the math right now. It's almost 10 years.
About seven. Okay. What inspired everybody to rap?
All of us together, man. We was really going through that shit. Broski know what the fuck going on. Yeah, we really had to get to that shit.
We've been this shit. We've been kind of had a name in this shit, you feel me? So we just had to keep this shit going. We the ones, we feel like, you feel me, we got to do this shit for our people to get us out the hood for real.
You know that.
So we going to do that. We going to stand on that bit. Yeah.
Okay.
You're right, gang.
What's your... What's your goal for 2024?
Man, my goal for 2024, man, just break through them doors with my brothers. We finna take off. We stacking this pay on my soul.
More opportunities, more shows, you feel me? And we just gonna get more lit on my soul.
All right,
one final question. What is your message?
You ain't always gotta be on no gang shit, bro. Like, and to the kids, to the shorties, y'all coming up.
I'm not talking about the kids. I'm talking about when somebody listens to your music, what are you trying to project?
This shit just entertainment, but at the same time, positive energy, man. That's what we displaying for.
I say if you win that shit, be one of them people that's trying to be a better change for the world.
On my soul.
For your people's on gang. If you ain't in this shit for the right reasons, you feel me? Then I mean, you influencing for the
they
wrong
They promote violence, bro. We trying to promote the peace for real, bro. We on some real shit, even though we
don't
talk
think
that shit.
But don't get like that on my soul.
We get like that for real, though. But we really pushing the peace, though, on my soul.
Another message, man, look, just stay. Keep all your peoples close.
On my soul. Yeah.
Ain't no friends, no buddies, none of that. If they not your brothers, fuck them, on my soul. If you can't call them your brother, don't have them around.
Light them up.
So, is there any brands y'all pushing? Like,
yeah, man. Life of a Roll Runner, man.
Life of a Roll Runner.
Oh, yeah, get out of here.
Tell them your Instagram.
Hey, do your job, security. Whoop, plug, drop the baby. Oh, shit, she be in the car. Make sure you keep this in the clip, too. Keep all this shit. Get all this shit. That shit crazy.
Y'all supposed to be security.
Y'all supposed to be security, boy. Great DJ tonight by DJ Tsunami. Shout out to my boy Stone, man. Stone, founder of Game Go Arcade. So if you guys ever need some arcade games, he's got 40 full-size arcade games at Paul Barney. He's awesome.
Greetings and the finest of salutations. Bill Crane, Crane's World TV, founder of Raw Talent Shy. We're here at The Forge out in Joliet, Illinois. I'm Vice President of Branding and Marketing for Throwback Cigars. So tonight we had an unsigned music festival for unsigned musical artists. And it's a great event.
So how long have you been in the business?
I started in the music industry in 2013 when I started working with Twista, the West Side Legend.
That's awesome. What influenced you to join the business, join the music business?
So I always grew up wanting to be in the NFL. and I played Division I football at Western Michigan with many NFL legends and stars. And first day of college football practice, I realized I had no chance. We were top 25 in the country, and I'm like, I wish I could be in the NFL, but it's not going to work out for me. Fast forward to when I'm 33, I met Twista, and then haven't looked back since. I'm now 43, been in the entertainment industry for 11 years working with celebrities.
That's awesome. Who inspired you to do this?
Zero inspiration. I was just in Twista's crew for almost a year and a half. So being around a star and celebrity like that, I'd be an idiot not to build my own brand and business. And then I started working with a bunch of old school rappers like Paul Wall and Bone Thugs and Harmony and all these old people. And then I started working with the new generation like Famous Dex and G Herbo and Lil Bibby. And, you know, here I am.
That's groovy. What's your goal for 2024?
Goal for 2024 is to be half as legendary as this year. So this has been a good year. I was with Lil Durk, Lil Baby, Mike Tyson, Hulk Hogan, G Herbo all over the country. I mean, it's been a crazy year. So hopefully 2024 could be half as good as a quarter, a hundredth as good as this year. It's been my best year of my career.
Okay, groovy. And one last question. What's your message? Not to the children, not to the people, but like when people listen to you, when people come to you or look at your brand.
So I do consultations for a living.
Yeah.
Right. And when I meet with people, I tell them to invest in their brand and business, build up their resume and their portfolio by working with stars and celebrities. Because how many up and coming artists are there in Chicago? Over 10,000. How many actually work with stars and celebrities? Not too many. So I'm a celebrity connector. And I also give people advice and I'm a consultant. So invest in your career financially. If you're not doing shows, hire you a musician. Anybody could record a video. Anybody can step into a booth and do a song. But who can step on stage in front of their own fans and accumulate new fans? Those are called musical artists. And most people in Chicago try and be artists so they can be cool with their guy friends and get girls. But real artists step on stage, like the people did tonight at the Forge out in Joliet.
All right.
And that's it.
All right, thank you, sir. I really appreciate
you know it.
Hey, Zion.